Nandito na naman po tayo sa ating programa kung saan magtatampo po tayo ng ating mga kababayang gaya po nating mga na OFW na magbabahagi sa atin ng kanilang mga kwento, mga makakatulong na impormasyon na kahit papaano makaagapay sa ating pang-araw-araw pamumuhay bilang mga overseas Filipino workers. Kaya, huwag po kayong aalis at susunod na ang Kabayan, Ikaw Na. Tin ay isang pretty lady. siya isang content compliance manager ng isang pamoso o malaking kumpanya dito, yung Alshaya Company. At kilalang personalidad dito sa Kuwait sa kanyang pag-host sa isang programa at malalaking events sa ating Filipino community. Ayan. At recently, into vlogging po siya. Sino siya? Kilalanin po natin. Nandito at bisita ko po si Mary Jane Nolasco.
Hello po.
Hello, hello MJ. Ayun, natuloy din.
Oo, natuloy din.
Ayun, matagal-tagal.
Thank you for inviting you.
Oh, salamat din sa pagpapaula kahit short notice.
Oo,
diba?
Okay lang yun.
Actually, mga next month pa dapat naka-schedule, pero buti na lang.
Oo nga. Sabi natin ka after Ramadan,
yes,
diba?
Anyway,
pero thank you very much.
Thank you for pagpapaulak mo na maging bisita ka natin. At kahit papaano ibahagi ang iyong munting kwento sa atin. Okay. Siguro, we'll start with, gano'n ka na ba katagal dito sa Kuwait?
I came 2003, so by September, 14 years.
Talaga? 14 years ka na dito sa
Kuwait? Tagal na.
Oo, talagang, hindi ko naman masabi dito ka talaga nagdalaga or ano.
Hindi naman, too old for that. No, when I came, I was 28. So.
28 talaga, okay.
You can do the math.
Oo, tapos, ayun nga, ikaw ngayon ay content compliance manager. Ano yun?
Sounds pwedeng, scary, di ba?
Sounds
scary.
Pakipaliwanag para
exactly.
I-educate mo kami. Ano ang ginagawa ng isang content compliance manager ng isang malaking company?
Actually, it sounds scary but it's not scary at the same time. Kasi ano lang siya, it's as simple as the compliance comes from, kasi I'm working as an advertising marketing expert.
So, talaga naman expert.
Yeah. I've been working in the same industry for like 18 years, I guess, to add it all up.
Okay.
Ang compliance only refers to yung being Alshaya. You know, we have a different tone of voice, a specific tone of voice when we talk to customers. So, and the company has guidelines for that. Alam mo na, yung pag-usap ka sa customer when you're saying sale, are you allowed to say sale on a specific time in different markets? Kasi may mga ministry restrictions and all that. But basically, the job is about advertising and marketing.
Ayun. Yeah, siyang,
very simple.
Siya, expertise mo naman.
Yeah.
Diba? Okay. So, ano ba ang kaibahan ng yun nga pagma-manage ng mga ganyan or trabahong kagaya ng sa iyo dito sa gitnang silangan as compared sa Pilipinas kasi naging manager
yes,
ka rin
I was doing the same thing.
Pareho
if I'm allowed I could say Robinson's group.
Okay,
I was doing the same job at Robinson's group. The only difference is that because here in the Middle East, medyo limited ka to what you can say based on restrictions by, you know, the ministry, the government could say. Let's say for example, if you're saying special offers or sale or you're coming up with new collection or you're saying I'm giving gift vouchers to customers. In some of the markets you'd be limited to saying coupons. You know, in Kuwait you might be able to say gift voucher 5 KD on a purchase of 25 KD. In Qatar, for example, in KSA you will not be allowed to say that.
Talaga?
Yes. In KSA, for example, hindi ka pwedeng mag-require ng minimum spend because doon it will sound as a gambling.
Okay.
So, kailangan sabihin mo lang, bigyan kita ng 5 KD.
Okay.
And the gist is, come to the store and I'll explain. Na kailangan mong bumili. Ganun din naman yun. But licensing issue. And basically, sa Pinas, we don't have limitations. Ang kaibahan lang ng job ko sa Philippines is because, in a Robinson's group, I was, there's someone taking care of the department store. And then the supermarket, I was taking care of hardware. The handyman.
Okay.
So, magkaiba. Hardware. And then now, I'm doing retail. You know, the top man, all these brands, H&M, it's totally different. Tapos, back in the Philippines, being doing advertising for Robinson's, ikaw lang mag-isa. In here, you have a team. And not only a team, it's the biggest team in the group where you are part of the corporate. So, lahat sila, like H&M has their own brand marketing team, they have a manager, executive coordinator, and all the other brands like American Eagle has their own. Uh-oh. And they all communicate with you.
Okay. Yeah. Pero sa atin, parang...
Ikaw lahat. Yes.
So. Doon ang kagandahan siguro niyan eh, yung sa naging training mo sa atin sa Pilipinas,
oh, yes.
Na-apply mo dito.
That actually kaya, qualified me for this job. Because I was in the store. Mm-mm. When I came, I was hired in the Philippines. They brought me to manage, as a store manager in Top Shop. Tapos after a year and a half, I think I was moved to another store, which mm-hmm. is in Marina Mall. Okay. And then in Marina Mall, there was a boss in the office that mm-hmm. that interested with my background in marketing.
Ayun.
So yeah, I was lucky.
Ayun. Yeah. Hindi lang swerte, dahil din sa kakayahan
it's
mo.
Never easy actually to come
dahil
to the head office.
Dahil napaka-talented mo rin, di ba? Ayan, at kilala rin si MJ sa pag-host niya ng isang... morning talk show ng isang kaibigan din.
Yes.
Napakagaling.
Kung may makakalaban.
Ricky Laksa. Lahat kaibigan natin dito. Ayan, si Ricky Laksa. Ayan, yeah. Ricky, if you're watching,
live in the Philippines.
Ayun. Ayun.
Ate Max.
si Maxi, hello. Yeah, mga kasabayan niya.
Uh-oh.
Okay. So, paano ka naman napunta sa talk show na to? Can you tell us a little bit about yung pag-host mo naman ng program na ito?
Actually, I was, I think, in Top Shop working as a store manager. Mm-hmm. And then, kung kilala mo si Ferdy Nadera, who was into fashion shows and beauty pageants.
Yes.
One of the siguro shopping times niya, he was in Top Shop. Okay. Tapos naghahanap siya ng host and then he approached me. Sabi niya, parang nakikita ko kasi nag-assist ako sa kanya. Okay. Parang you do a good host. Sabi ko, actually, I was doing hosting back in the Philippines. Mm-hmm. I was working as a broadcaster in one of the TV shows. Mm-hmm. I had shows. So sabi niya, I wanna try you out. So yung pinakaunang OFW pageant mm-hmm. was hosted by Ricky and I was paired with Ricky.
Okay, doon na lang.
Si Ate Maxi was there also. Okay. Ayun.
Ayun, that's all.
And then I saw you on some of many shows actually. Di ba? You were Bossa Nova Queen.
Ayun. Ayun. Kaya, yun na, magandang experience. At yun, babalik tayo sa sinabi mo nga, nag-host ka rin at nakapagtrabaho ka sa TV5 sa Bacolod.
Yes, right? SBN TV5.
Okay, dahil ang background mo is, ang kursong natapos mo is
Mass Communications
yes. sa broadcasting.
Yes.
Okay, so paano nakatulong itong background mo into sa broadcasting sa pag-host mo?
Actually, actually, parang the other way around because I started hosting.
And so nauna ka sa pag-host?
I started hosting kasi very busy ako as a kid talaga. As a teenager, I was very busy kasi poor kid. You know, coming from a family, a big family with 10 siblings, napakagulo. Mm-hmm. And then, walang pera. So, I had to survive. Alam niyo? So, racket. And
ayun,
then,
raketera.
Siyempre. Magaling tayo dyan.
Okay.
Kung sa may racket, nandun ako.
Correct.
And then, yes. And then, some of the friends, parang nalaman nila. And then, alam mo yun, parang siguro, if you're really tuned in to becoming this somebody, into this field, parang doon ka talaga papunta. If you focus on it. So, parang, when there were shows, even in school, tapos pag kailangan ng host, and then the host doesn't show up, they just pick me up, kalas! Come here!
Host,
or a t-shirt, and all that. Oh, okay. I remember I was in third year college, uh-huh. parang wala silang host, and then suddenly, alam, sige, from the audience, sige, ikaw na! Mm-hmm. I actually took up mass communication because I was already hosting.
Ayun.
So parang the other way around, and then okay. It just, ano, parang molded me, parang naging, ano na lang siya, shaping me ready for the field talaga.
Okay, ganun. Ayan nga, kasi masasabi kong, hindi para sa lahat
yes.
itong larangan natin.
Yes,
diba?
Actually, like, most of my friends would tell me, when you have the microphone, like, I think I would run out of words to say,
mm-mm.
pero tayo, iba, diba, addict? Pagkakahawak ng microphone, daldal lang daldal, walang tigil. So, alam mo yun, it's always a forte.
Okay.
I think, yeah. And then, it's up to you to hone your skills and your talent. Uh-oh. It has to be skills and talent at the same time. Eh.
Okay. Uh-oh. So, balik mo kami dun sa time mo sa TV5. Paano yung experience mo dun? Paano yung unang punta mo? Di ka ba parang
scary?
Natakot?
Super.
Paano ba yung competition dun? Is it really... stiff ba yung competition doon? Or mabait naman sila na naturoan ka talaga.
Actually, it's all accidental. Alam mo talaga, when future leads you to something you have, you will be doing the future, parang piniprepare ka lang. At the time I knew the station manager, parang he was a Negros Press Club president at that time. I met him in Cebu Pacific. I was
in Cebu
Pacific.
Po, Ilongga.
Yes, Bacolod. Okay. I met him in Cebu Pacific. He was buying his ticket to go somewhere. Okay. So sabi niya nga, you know, I would need a host, parang gano'n. At the time, I was a fresh graduate. And, you know, taking experience.
Mga fresh graduate, go-getter.
Tapos sinabi niya, you know, if you'd come to the station, I'd try you out. Ganyan. Tapos, nag-start lang naman sa parang feature lang si SBN. Actually, it was Radio 1 at that time. Tapos sabi niya, wala siya kasi masyadong tao. Mm-hmm. So, the SBN TV 5, the Radio 1 was my way of having the SBN TV 5 documentary show. Exactly. Okay. And he didn't have people. So, all I did was like, ako, nagre-research at the same time, script writing at the same time, hosting, which is the cameraman. Traveling by jeepneys and buses.
Talaga?
Yes, we didn't have a radio station, you know, service at that time because it was starting.
Correct, okay. So doon nag-start yung training mo. Which, kahit pa pala, nakatulong din, di ba? Sa abi mo nga, it honed your skill even more, dinevelop pa. Further,
yes.
Diba?
And then when I was in college, I became part of the Bombo Radio because I wanted the accreditation. I was further trained by Bombo Radio also with the experience. So, sabi ko no college.
Paano yung training mo doon? Is it rigid or
actually, Bombo Radio was we were part time, you know, researching for specific shows. Okay. I was more into show with Bombo because I think girls.
Okay.
We're so into chismes. Okay. And then at the same time, I was doing feature researching for a program like, you know, when it's Holy Week, stories or Holy Week and all this stuff, and then Christmas and stuff like that. And then at the same time, I was doing a beat reporting with somebody from Bombo Radio himself. So,
paano yung pagsasanay mo doon para sa field reporting.
Yes, you were recording your own audio for airing. Mm-hmm. Tapos, at that time, wala pa mga Facebook Live. So, kahit anong damit mo, okay lang. Mm-hmm. And then, but the most important thing is that you'd have, like, yung unique voice mo. Uh-huh. And then, a certain radio station, you would know na 95.5 FM siya because of a particular, you know, yung pausing and then pronunciation of something. Uh-oh. And then, at that time, in Bombo Radio, we were doing Tagalog and English at the same time. In Ilonggo, the Ilonggo was very difficult kasi alam mo na Tagayan niya naging news report ka kanina. The Tagalog is different, diba? Mas deeper siya, alam mo yun, mas formal language siya than the usual language na ginagamit. Totoo. Ganun din sa Ilonggo. Ang hirap actually ng Ilonggo communication.
Ay, siguro nga, yung nga pag regional dialect na pinag-uusapan, ako hindi ko alam kung makakabasa ako ng straight na Kapampangan.
Exactly. di ba Kapampangan ka, ako Ilonggo. But most people would ask me, bak parang, siguro kaya walang tono masyado yung Tagalog ko because I'm used to Tagalog in English and Ilonggo at the same time. Medyo mahirap yung Tagalog to switch.
Tama. From kasi Ilonggo. Yung iba, yung sa regional, lalo na sa regional dialect, minsan nadadala nung punto.
Sa
pagbabalita. Diba?
Alam mo yung, ganito, parang, sige, pag nagsalita yung tao, alam mo na, isang region siya nang galing, di ba may gano'n?
Tama.
Siyempre, through training, na natatanggal din naman talaga siya.
Tapos napunta ka nga sa advertising and public relations. So buti na lang hindi mo tinuloy ang karera mo sa media.
Actually, I wanted to come back because I was on SBN TV 5. The pay last time, the last thing I remember was like 3,600 pesos. I would not really live with 3,600. I have to support my family.
Which is sad, di ba?
Yeah,
sa
very
atin,
sad, you know?
Kung mag-start ka, pag nagsisimula kang maging isang yung field reporter or
you have
journalist
to,
talagang
really. Alam mo yung bumabiyahe kayo, you only have 100 pesos in your pocket, tapos kailangan mo mag-bus and then i-refund mo lang after, 2 weeks? Tapos, ang sahod mo gets delayed. Pagdating na sahod mo, patong na utang mo.
Para sa impormasyon nga po ng ating mga kababayan, hindi po madali ang magsimula sa karera ng media sa atin sa Pilipinas. Like you, ganyan din, nagsimula ako and then kagaya mo, napunta sa yung next thing sa journalist, being a journalist is yun nga, public relations at saka yun nga, promotion, advertisements.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's why natempt ako when I was offered to go to Manila.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi, okay, Cebu Pacific. You know the Cebu Pacific Rewards program, the get-go right now?
Okay.
Yes. That was the same scheme kasi when when it was launched, I was in Cebu Pacific, one of the ticket agents, because it's a ticket agent, basically, company. So sabi nila, oh, parang may offers sa Manila. So I said, okay, I'd grab the opportunity. I went to Manila. Tapos wala din naman pala.
Mm-hmm.
So, basically, it opened, alam mo yun, when God plans something for you, parang it doesn't happen this way, kasi ito yung gusto mo, it doesn't happen like that all the time.
But you destined ka sa,
exactly.
Sa isang profession,
so,
pupunta ka rin.
Exactly, that's when the PR field opened for me, na IA. So, I was employed by Nirenkin International Airport, that was MIA at that time. For public relations, you know, basically the ones who are in the reception area that you ask for your travel to Hong Kong, these codes na may malaking boards sa likod mo.
Yun.
And then you man the VIP areas like the VIP lounges where senators, dignitaries, travel.
Very ano ka siguro rin, kailangan alam mo yung mga pangalan.
Yes.
Very, very quick.
Because even before that, the secretaries would send you yung itineraries and the names of whoever's coming with them. So kailangan kilala mo, like Richard Gomez, I assisted him before.
Mm-hmm.
There, there was a VIP paid thing because you can also pay for VIP assistance.
Ah. Ganun ba yun?
I think that time 2000 yung binayad. And then you get tips. So, di ba?
Ang dami natin natututunan kay MJ.
Masyado na po akong marami.
Pero ayun nga, siguro, kung ikaw ang papipiliin kung ano talaga ang gusto mong karera, it's...
I go back to broadcast.
Natututunan kay MJ.
Masyado na po akong marami.
Pero ayun nga, siguro, kung ikaw ang papipiliin kung ano talaga ang... gusto mong karera, it's...
I go back to broadcasting.
Broadcasting, yes. Okay.
That's what really, I think,
why?
I love the most. It's kasi kagaya ng ginagawa mo. And gone are the days that you'd have to write things. That's why I opened vlogging.
Ayun, no. Ayan.
Kasi mas...
Ano tayo sa vlogging ngayon?
Paano
ka napunta sa vlogging na yan? Anong kaibahan ng vlogging sa vlogging?
Ayun. Yeah, see, I'm a busy person. When I started vlogging, it was, I think, in 2007, I was hosting. So, sabi ko, there's a lot of events to write up about.
Mm-hmm.
So, write tayo. And then, you know, I'd spend hours in Starbucks and the coffee shops para lang magsulat and then put up with the pictures. You know, that time, Friendster pa. I have blogs on Friendster na parang na-lose na. So, and then after some time, parang kakasawa. Wala, kasi busy ka sa work and then you have other events to do. Busy ka din sa mga racket. So, okay, iwanan na natin. And then, months ago, my niece introduced me to vloggers.
Oh, yun na update na ngayon. Hindi na siya vlogger, kundi vlogging. Ano ang difference nito?
It's only basically not writing anymore. It's talking. Like this, I'm recording.
Okay.
Because I'm gonna release this as a vlog.
Using video.
Yes,
yeah, okay.
It's video vlogging. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's a combination of that. So, ayun, for... tapos sabi ng niece ko, alam mo, ay, kumikita sila. Ako, I'm doing this naman.
Napapagkitaan
niya? Yes. Yes. Yung pinakamataas yung market na, I mean, Filipino-American vlogger natin that's based in the Philippines is traveling right now.
Uh-huh.
Si Will Dasovich, if you wanna follow him, follow me also, please. My channel is Jay Nolasco.
Ayun, yan. So, gusto nga mag-subscribe o mag-follow sa'yo. Okay.
I've just started my vlog. Sabi ko nga kasi, the videos
kailan
that
start?
Are...
Kailan next start?
Vlogging just 2 months or a month ago, actually. It started 6 years ago, like putting, I've been putting my videos on the channel, sa YouTube, kasi sabi ko, putting it on the files, you'd lose it eventually.
Okay.
Diba? Mawawala mo flash drive, external drive, so put it on YouTube, you can always find it there, Jay Nolasco, and then you'd find it.
Uh-huh.
All of them, mga hosting na, mga videos na
Jay Nolasco, ayun.
Yes,
J-N-O-L-A-S-C-O. Nolasco, yan, follow po
ninyo. So, ayun, so when I was watching, sabi ko, parang ang sarap naman niya. Whatever you do, kasi sabi ng asawa ko, when we traveled in Europe last December, you're already actually videoing and talking on the video yourself.
Correct.
So why don't you do vlogging at the same time? Because it's like that compiled videos of yours.
Diba tayo, mahilig mag-selfie-selfie dyan. Ano
exactly.
Ba? Kaya mag-video-video.
Ayun.
At least, nabibigyan mo ng information. Ano ang usual content ng vlogging?
Para
sa mga those interested into vlogging. What
like
can
vlogging,
you
know, you have this direction.
Mm-hmm.
Akin naman, this time I'm doing the travels, because the December travels,
okay,
binavlog ko pa siya. I'm just okay. doing intros and then putting them all together. Pero I think it will be traveling at the same time. It's okay. just that if traveling kasi nasa Kuwait tayo, and we okay. don't travel as much, you know,
right,
that
right.
we have to earn para yes. mag-travel, and it's not
more
much.
More tayo.
Oh, so at the same time, I'm putting it halfway events like this.
Okay.
Kasi it's vlogging is like featuring yourself on a daily basis. Kahit anong ginagawa mo, you can put it up there.
Okay.
So wag lang mga foul languages
oh,
and
yes.
foul things. Yeah.
So mga paunang tips sa mga like you, it's just recently na nag-start ka into vlogging. So anong mapapayo mo sa mga gustong yan, mag-start sa kanilang pagba-vlog.
Oo. Actually, kapal talaga ng mukha. Una sa lahat, kapal ng mukha. Actually, makapal ng mukha ko. But when I'm recording, and then my husband faces me, and I'm talking on the phone, hindi ko kaya. Like, I'd say, hindi ko kaya.
Sasabihin ko sana, anong mapapayo mo para maging comfortable? Like you, diba? Parang nako-conscious ka, diba? Para maging comfortable ka in front of a camera, or kaya sa stage. Ano
kaya,
pwede mong ibigay na tip sa atin?
Isipin mo na lang. You know what? One tip I could say, like you when you're hosting, basta paghawak mo ng microphone or you face your phone here because we're talking mm-hmm. about vlogging now. Pag face mo ng microphone, paghawak mo ng microphone, this is what I do on stage kasi I don't care whoever is there.
Uh-huh.
Like people will not always like you. There are people okay. who doesn't like you and who will not even bother to like you at all.
Yes.
They won't like you,
okay.
whatever you do. Mm-hmm. So don't care about them.
Okay,
if you hold a microphone,
people pleaser,
exactly. Mm-hmm. You know, you don't have to be two-faced to try, you know, convince people to like you. You don't have
yes.
to do that. This is your channel. This is you.
Be yourself.
Yeah, exactly. So if I hold the microphone, I say something, it's like, whether I did something wrong,
parang,
they won't even
or
notice.
Parang nagigipag-usap ka sa
exactly.
kaibigan mo, di ba?
Oo. Basta, hosting on stage is different from vlogging. Dito, sarili mo.
Mm-hmm.
On stage, you're presenting someone. Then,
oh, yeah.
You know, most of the time,
may crowd ka.
Yeah. So, magre-research ka. Here, magre-research ka. But it's mm-hmm. all about what you want to say.
Okay.
Go on what you want to say, and at the same time, research about the people you introduce.
You,
so you have to be factual. Yeah. I mean, factual gathering would be important.
Mm-hmm.
The equipments, actually, right now, I'm not planning to invest on equipments yet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this small microphone.
Okay.
It's because it's not something that I do to earn at this time.
Uh-huh.
Hindi naman ako nag-earn dito, like, kagaya ng racket ko hosting that I'm paid for
correct,
hours,
correct,
like corporate events that
mm-hmm.
I'm hosting that pays me 30,000 pesos
mm-hmm.
for one event. This is not about that.
Mm-hmm.
Siguro ito eventually.
Ano lang, passion na, interest.
Yes.
Okay.
So, kailangan ka pala mo ka, vlogging needs equipments. But for a starter like me,
uh-oh.
Kailangan nyo lang mag-app dyan, download ng apps for editing because you have to edit the
ako, like me, very low-tech ako.
Oh, actually, low-tech din ako. I'm starting to learn.
Kailangan matuto ka talaga. Para makaagapay sa
yes.
Modernidad.
So for me, the first step is this small microphone so that
okay.
yung audio mas okay. Kasi alam mo yung wind blowing sometimes would not have the clear audio.
So yun.
Actually, if you're doing it that because you only like doing it, hindi naman kailangan mag-invest talaga. Yeah, there are apps available na pwedeng mag-edit
mm-hmm.
and then put your videos together. Hindi ka kailangan magbayad to have 10 minutes or 15 minutes video on YouTube. I'm starting as a 5-minute video or
mm-hmm.
vlogger.
And one thing, paano ang kagandahan nga ng social media ngayon? Ayan, merong simpareng Google nandiyan.
Exactly. Simpareng na lang.
Simpareng YouTube, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
YouTube. Kumbaga, kung pwede ka mag-self-study.
Yes.
Di ba? Para
I'm just watching vlogs lang din.
And,
like yesterday, there was a vlog from LeBlanc. He's one of the most popular vloggers. That vlog was actually in time for new vloggers like me. Kasi nakalagay doon what equipments he uses.
Okay.
Oh my God, drones are very important. But that's expensive.
Mahal
350,000. No, I'm not ready to pay for that.
Uh-huh.
Para lang sa travel. I'd rather use my phone. I'm okay with this. I'm not paid
correct.
Yet as a vlogger. Maybe
yes.
when I'm paid already later, pag nag-subscribe kayo.
Yeah, mag-subscribe now.
Because
support ka si MJ.
Exactly. Sa YouTube kasi, like Baninay, who was at PBB, no? sa PBB house ni Kuya.
Lagi ba siya ngayon?
Yes, because of Will Dasovich. What basically Will Dasovich is doing, he's the most popular vlogger.
Okay.
So, ang ginagawa niya, pagbarkada niya, mag-vlog ka na rin, and then all his viewers will subscribe to you.
Ayun.
So, yun. So, parang ganun.
So, isang tip po yan, yung mga vloggers wannabe, or gusto mag-start into vlogging. Diba?
Mm-mm.
Magandang paraan po yan. And, yun nga, kung ikaw ay taong mahilig makipagkwentuhan, maboka, ikaw nga, mahilig makipagchikahan,
yes.
Diba? I-develop nyo yung talent ninyo.
You can never be stopped by people talking about you or saying something na hindi mo kayang gawin.
Sure.
This is what you wanna do, just do it. Don't care about them.
Correct.
Kasi hindi naman sila magmamold for you in the future. Would they help you kung, alam mo, may kailangan ka na...
Correct.
Hindi naman magagaling sa kanila.
So, yun nga, nasa larangan nga tayo ng, yun nga, sa media and to talking to people. Diba, meron ka pa bang karera or any field na naisubukan o...
Actually, no.
Talaga?
I think that's it.
It has always been...
rolled into one. Marketing, PR, sales, advertising, broadcasting.
Ito talaga ang gusto mong larangan.
I don't see myself working as an engineer, as a chemical or chemist, for example. Hindi talaga.
Chef.
No, oh my God. That's one thing I would like to do, but I never like dreamed of.
Husband mo ba naglinito?
Hindi siya. Nagbabayad lang kami. Para lutuan.
Ayun.
For me.
Hindi.
Of all the things you can call me or tell me about, yung food, kahit anong ingredients, oh my God. No,
okay.
I'm so bad at that.
So, yan talagang yung passion.
Doon ako...
No. Iba-iba tayo ng field of expertise.
Oo,
ikaw
diba?
Na, diba?
Eh, kapampangan ka sa magaling ka.
Actually, mag-aaral akong culinary.
Oh! So, the irony of being kapampangan. Because, ano yun, claim din yung pagka, oh, magaling.
Yes, parang maging full-time ano, chef, diba? Yan, abangan
yes.
Nyo yan.
I-vlog mo na rin yan.
O nga, diba, parang yung start mo to be it.
Oh.
Anyway, yun nga, mabalik tayo sa'yo. Okay, so where do you see yourself, mga say 10 years from now?
Actually, the plan is really going home.
Oh,
I'd really love the Philippines.
Siguro nga.
So, I mean, to settle back in the Philippines.
Oh, that's very touching.
Yeah.
Oh, nga.
Actually, really, kasi I was young. Kasi sabi ko nga, if not for the need, lang financial need to be able to provide my nieces
maganda
and nephews
ang Pilipinas.
To school. The life in the Philippines would be lovely if you're able to save for it. But umuwi ka, may savings ka, and you have properties that you can call your own, or you call your own already. Mm-hmm. Napakasarap po ng buhay sa Pinas.
And I was talking to a friend earlier, yun nga, sabi niya, yeah, siya mag-migrate sa, ano, sa New Zealand yata. So,
that would be lovely. Pero yun siguro
ko,
gusto nila.
Hindi, ako gusto ko uwi ng Pinas.
Pag may pera ka, and sabi ko nga eh, kahit naman ako,
magkaroon ng,
I didn't plan of going abroad, like, Kuwait. Pero, if it's really meant for you, it could happen. Na-hire ako 2 weeks after, I was flying to Kuwait. So, hindi ko naman pinlana yun.
Ayan. Siguro, pag-pray lang for guidance, and yun nga, if you already know yung skill na meron ka, i-develop it further.
Yes, because, kaya mo kumita dun, actually.
Okay. At dahil gawin na tayo sa time, anyone that you want to,
bati.
Bati nga, bati
so, mga tigabakolin lang, yun. Sa Papang ko, hi Papang, and get well, ha?
Nice
sa mga kaibigan sa Kuwait, thank you for the support, guys. Kayo yung mga followers ko, eh. So, soon, magbabakolo din tayo. Marami pa tayo kaklase.
Ayan, and since you're into hosting, baka may gustong kumuha sa'yo sa pag-hosting. Pwede mo
actually,
bigay number mo?
Oh, actually, well, sana, the parokya ni Edgar is still happening because it was supposed to happen in after Ramadan niya. It was booked in April, eh. sana mangyari pa parokya ni Edgar. We're also excited about that. So, sabi niya kasi, it might push through September.
Uh-oh.
But anyway, yeah, so mga gusto kumuha sa akin for events hosting, I'm just here.
Paano kanila
you can call me at 553-666-49.
FB page?
Yes. FB page is MjBuscadoNolasco, YouTube channel Jane Nolasco for vlogging. Just send me a message. I have a lot of friends in Kuwait, so kung Kuwait based ka, it won't be a problem.
Yan. And thank Thank you so much. We've learned a lot, Ms. MJ. Sa pagpapaunla po. At gahong na po tayo ng, sa time. Hindi ko na po iisa-isahin ang ating mga kasama. Maraming salamat po sa isang very entertaining and napaka-sayang programa natin sa hapong ito ng Kabayan Ikaw Na. Sa ngalan po ng ating mga nakasama, ito po si Juana Pangilina, nagpapaalala sa lahat. Life is good, live it right. Give thanks to God Almighty every day. God is great all the time. Inyo pong napakinggan ang pagsasahing papawid ng Radio Kuwait Filipino Service. 763 kHz sa medium wave at 93.3 MHz FM band. Ang Radio Kuwait Filipino Service ay inyong maririnig sa buong rehiyon ng Gulpo at sa Timog Silang bahagi ng Asia sa 21,580 kHz at 16.77 meter band sa shortwave. Maraming salamat po! Mabuhay!